I have the Redmi Note 13 Pro here, and in today's video, I'll be showing you how to install the Google Play Store, Google Play Services, and all of the other apps that are required to use them. In the past, this has been much more difficult since it required us to find and install a Google Play Store installer that was compatible with the actual device itself. But that doesn't seem to be the case with the Redmi Note 13 series. So this should work with the Pro model that I have right here, the base version of the Redmi Note 13, the more premium Redmi Note 13 Pro Plus, and even the Redmi Note 13 R. And I should point out that this is the Chinese version of HyperOS as well, as indicated with the CN letters that are included in the OS version area. The phone I have here is still bootloader locked too, so there isn't any need to switch to another firmware at all. To install the Google Play Store on the Redmi Note 13 series, we simply need to open up the Settings application. And then we're going to scroll down through this list until you find the additional settings area. Then we're going to scroll through this menu again until you find the accounts and sync menu. Now here, you should see a feature called basic Google services. So let's tap on that. And right at the top, we can enable this feature by tapping on the toggle for basic Google services so that we can use the Google Play Store, Google Play Services, Google Maps, Gmail, and much, much more. So all we have to do is tap on that toggle as I did. And after that has been enabled, it may take a little bit of time for the apps to be downloaded and installed. Now, if you don't see the apps in the home screen anywhere, that's okay. We're going to find the Get Apps App Store screen. And then do a search for Google Play. You should see a Google Play Store app in this list, and it needs to be updated. So we're going to tap on that update button. And then we're going to let that application be updated in the background. Again, you may need to be patient to let other apps be updated as well. But eventually you should find the Google Play Store application in your home screen. Once the app has been updated, you can open it up and then log into your Google account so that you can finish through with the setup process. Then once everything's done, you have full access to the Google Play Store, where you can install apps and games just like you normally would. As mentioned, Google Play services will also be installed and set up, which is why Xiaomi makes a note about a slight reduction in battery life. It's just the trade-off that we must accept in order for many of these apps and games to function properly. So let me know if you ran into any issues while following along with this guide. And don't forget to like this video while subscribing to the channel here for more Redmi Note 13 content like this.